Yeah, GPT-4o is a new model from OpenAI. They had their spring launch event yesterday and gave us a new model, and it's free for the public to use. Paid subscriptions, of course, get a little bit more action with it every month. But let's dive in here. In addition to the new model, we also got a new desktop app. So that's what I'll be using today to try out GPT-4o. So, yeah, there's lots that this new model offers. One of the main things about this new model is that instead of three kids in a trench coat doing the multimodal stuff that we had before, this is an all-in-one true single model doing multimodal. And in order to do that, they had to create a new tokenizer, which leads me to believe that this is actually one of the first public checkpoints of GPT-5. All right, so let's play with this a little bit. So this is one of the more common tests that people like to do with new models. If it takes 5 hours to dry one shirt in the sun, how long does it take 20 shirts to dry? GPT-3.5 gets this wrong every time. Let's see what it says. It will still take 5 hours to dry 20 shirts. Yeah, that's perfect. Assuming they're all spread out, blah, blah, blah. And yeah, that's absolutely perfect. Just for comparison, let's try 3.5 with the same question. It says, you know, 5 times 20. That's how long it takes to dry 20 shirts. But it's not taking into consideration that they can all dry at the same time, which is the subtlety that the newer models are cluing into, which is cool. All right, so let's make a new chat for a little bit more complicated prompt. So here I'm asking it to make an interface for a MongoDB database. And I have some requirements there. I want it to be asynchronous and efficient, and let's see what it does. Yeah, so notice right away how fast this is, right? I mean, that is just amazingly fast. New code highlighting with the app. I love this.
I honestly can't believe that. I actually cannot believe how quickly it generated this. I was blown away before at the speed. Now it's just otherworldly to me, to be honest.
Yeah, and it's doing type hinting automatically. I didn't even ask for that, which is awesome, the type annotations. And it gives examples in the doc strings. And this doc string is fantastic. This is just, yeah, I'm blown away. I really like this model a lot. Not only that, but notice it used Motor to create the database connection. If you're not familiar, Motor is kind of the not the industry standard way to do this. It's a way to do it that is asynchronous natively instead of the more common PyMongo. So I think this is just really advanced, and it's on the money. I love it. Should we do something even harder? I have another prompt here ready to go. This is also a common one that you'll see in testing new models. I want it to make the snake game in Python. Let's try 3.5. Okay, so we're going for object orientation right out of the gate, which is cool. This looks pretty legit. Let's try it out. So I have a Python project which is empty, all ready to go in PyCharm. So let's go ahead and make this. I'm just going to paste in the code, not even going to touch it. There it is. We do need to install Pygame real quick though. All right, that's all installed and ready to go. Let's go ahead and run this. Uh-oh. Well, it's not perfect yet. Let's go ahead and give this another shot with 4.0. All right, so here we go. Create the game Snake in Python. It's starting off pretty similar.
Still blows my mind how fast this is. You know, I had it analyze page earlier to try to pull out specific rules for a configuration thing that I was doing, and it did so without breaking a sweat. It was really cool.
All right, so let's switch back over to PyCharm, paste in some code. All right, so here's our game. And I died. It
Challenging game.
is a challenging game.
That is cool.
Oh, it didn't eat the pellet.
It's got the movement right. Interesting.
Well, all right, I'd say it's better, but it's not quite there yet. This is kind of an intermediary model. It's not the final thing, like I was saying before. I think this is one of the early checkpoints of GPT-5. It does have a lot of benefits and a lot of improvements over previous models, but it's not perfect yet. Do you guys have any other questions?
I do actually. With the speed that we're seeing that this thing is capable of, and some of the other features that admittedly we can't really test right now because apparently there are so many other people using them. I've been seeing a question around a lot of message boards and things lately, which is people panicking or being excited that AGI is here. So, what do you think? Do we
Nope.
have that yet?
Nope. This is not AGI yet. Not only that, but I really don't believe that the transformer type models are going to deliver AGI. I just think it's outside of the possibilities for that given architecture the way it is. We need to continue development if we want to really get AGI. Not only that, but I think OpenAI knows that this technology is incapable of AGI? Yeah, I'll leave it to the reader why I might think that.
I'm interested in the market dynamics of this right now. OpenAI releasing this model freely outside of the pro plan. I'm assuming this is to compete with the influx of open source models and position OpenAI more ubiquitously amongst consumers. And I'm kind of wondering if it's also a regulatory capture maneuver where they're trying to make the argument that they're good faith players in the market and gain the good graces of regulators. But
Yeah, I think that's part of it. I think there's another key part of it that comes down to money. It's faster than GPT-3.5. It uses less resources than GPT-3.5. It's cheaper for them to offer this model free.
it uses fewer resources under the hood.
That's how it's faster.
Does that speed increase come almost entirely from the combination of those multimodal, what were previously separate modes, into one?
Partially. I think there's other factors that play into it. They're not exactly open with how they create their models, so it's really hard to speculate too much. They also got a bunch of new hardware from NVIDIA recently, so it's probably a combination of a whole bunch of things that make it faster, not just one thing. All right, some closing thoughts here. I think this is a major step forward. Like I said, it's not AGI yet, and I think I know why people are clamoring about it being another step towards AGI, and that is the speed of the model is such that we can now have real-time conversations with it. Yeah, even the mode button isn't available. There should be a button right down here that allows me to go into microphone mode. There is a microphone here, but that's just going to capture my voice, kind of uninteractively, if you will, and it just puts the text here. The other mode that they demoed was really cool because you can have a live real-time conversation with it, and I think that is what is really piquing people's interest and making people think that this might be AGI. I don't know how much I'm going to use that. I was never really got into using Siri at all. I think it'll be amazing for people who use it for accessibility needs, right? Being able to create a document or even do some coding through an AI voice assistant. I think that just sounds really cool for a lot of people.
It's like the perfect debug duck. Imagine just having this running on the side and talking through what you're doing.
Yeah, totally. All right, folks, that's all I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed this little short session about GPT-4o.
And if you found this interesting, be sure to apply to Silicon Society's Beta. We're a network of current and aspiring technologists with the mission to humanize tech in the age of AI. Observe and learn from experienced engineers as they tackle real-world projects as part of our structured shadowing experience, get access to exclusive events, and level up in real life. Spots are filling up super fast, so nab your spot as a founding member.